Hi, Dmitry Mironov speaking. I'm IBM champion for power systems. I'm from IX Portal, first Russian-speaking independent community of IT professionals. We like to share our expertise, and in this presentation I wish to show you fascinating technology power enterprise pools. Let's dream. What if you have two cars? But you don't need to drive both at once. You use the first one for your daily trips and the second one for fun. Can you save some money? Probably, if you can share your engine between your cars. In such case, you will save not on initial acquisition, but on running costs like technical support, insurance, taxes, and so on. Sounds fantastic. Never stop dreaming, but go back to our reality. Let's look at the typical IT infrastructure. Usually, we have a production environment, which is heavily utilized. And we have a standby one, which is under zero or about zero utilization. But we need to have the same amount of resources at our standby complex, because it should always be up and ready to serve our workloads in case of any planned and unplanned downtimes. We agree to pay a lot for our production environment, because it runs our business. But what about standby one? We pay the same amount of money, but we don't use it. Can we reduce our expenses? Yes, we can save our money if we can move processor cores between two servers. Is this a teleportation? No. This technology is not on the market yet. It's power enterprise pools. How does it work? One of the cost drivers in power systems is CPU core. Enterprise-level power systems processor cores cost consists of two parts. First, hardware chip itself, and the second, cores activation, virtualization and operating system like AIX or IBMI licenses. Similar rules applies for memory. We pay for memory modules, DIMMs, and activations of gigabytes. We don't have to buy all activations from the start. We may add them on the fly, on demand, without stopping our environment. It's quite known technology. The name of this technology is capacity on demand. And in modern power systems, it's possible to use mobile activations for processor cores and gigabytes of memory, and move them between your servers just 10 seconds. Let's look at this example. There are three systems with some active static cores in brown color, active mobile cores in blue color, some cores are still inactive in black color. System A and System C are underutilized. We have a lot of free resources. But System B needs more processing power to serve our workload. In such case, we just move some activations from System A and System C to System B. There are still the same amount of active cores, but they are rebalanced, and we may use our processing capacity to serve our business better. Power Enterprise Pools technology show its best in combination with multiply shared processor pools and clusters like PowerHA. It allows you to use your resources more efficiently. It increases the return of your investment. The time of this presentation is limited, so I will not show you how to set up the Power Enterprise pool. I will show you just one more example. I've heard this question a lot of times. Yes, it's understandable how to move activations between systems, but what if the first system is gone? For example, in case of some disaster, can we move activations from the system that is not existing more? Is it possible? Yes. And I will show you a real live example how to do it. Oops. Production system is done. It's gone. Disappeared. Not on screen. Check that we still have 2.5 free cores on standby system. But we need more processing power. And we need to provide this power very, very fast. We are happy, because we already set up our Power Enterprise pool. But all our 40 cores are in use. Check that we already use 14 cores at the unavailable server and 26 cores as a second one. In this example, we don't need to move all 14 cores. So we are trying to move only 4 cores from the disconnected server. Oh, and we failed. Resources cannot be removed from server because the server cannot be reached. Is it a dead end? No. We just need to apply some magic. It's an exception. So we have to use the command line to move cores from the failed system with the force option. We may free only all cores from the disconnected system, so we remove all 14 cores. It works! Check that we have removed all 14 cores from the disconnected system, and now we have 14 cores available in the pool, and we may provide these cores to the second system. Notice that we got a warning message that 14 mobile processors on this server are unreturned. We must re-establish a connection with this server in 48 hours to resolve the compliance state of the mobile processors. Otherwise, the unreturned processors on this server will become overdue and the Power Enterprise pool will be out of compliance. So, we have to fix this situation within 48 hours. Check that we have 14 cores in unreturned state. Okay. We wish to move 4 cores to the second system. 26 plus 4 results 30. Yes, we did it. We successfully moved 4 cores to the second system, resulting 30 mobile cores. We still have 10 more available cores in the pool if we need to move more. Check that 14 cores are still in the unreturned state because we cannot connect to the failed system. Do you remember that there were 2.5 free cores? Now we have 6.5 available cores at our system, and we may use this cores to our production environment to run our business. We saved our business with the Power Enterprise Pools technology. Finally, we have repaired and started our failed system. All unreturned resources have been reclaimed for this Power Enterprise pool, and the pool is back in compliance. Check that there are no more unreturned cores in the pool. We may manually move or rebalance activations between systems if we need it. Rules, regulations, limitations, disclaimers, there are always a lot of them in any technology. Mobile activations cost more than static ones. Not all power systems are compatible with Power Enterprise pools. And you even cannot combine all compatible systems in one pool. But you may join your Power 7, Power 7 Plus, Power 8 and in the nearest future, power 9 systems in one pool. Ask your local IBM representative or IBM champion to learn more. My time is limited, so I cannot show you all functions and benefits of the Power Enterprise pools. I just wish to remind you that this technology do its best in combination with multiply shared processor pools and clusters, allowing you to use your processing power in full. Don't waste your resources. Use this technology and you will see all benefits. Do you remember my example about cars? With the Power Enterprise pools technology, you may share even not the whole engine, but a part of it, and drive both your cars at once. No one size fits all. I cannot say that any technology is suitable to any situation, but probably it's your size. Try this one. Maybe you will have some benefits from it. Thank you for your attention. I'm Dmitry Mironov, IBM champion for power systems. I'm from iX Portal, independent community of IT professionals. I'll be glad to answer your questions. You may contact me by email or find me at the Facebook. Thank you. See you next time.